Local hapū in Northland have the answer. A month ago, they placed a rāhui on gang violence in the town of Kaikohe. And since then, there has not been any reported gang violence. Tensions have simmered. We're joined by the organiser of that customary ban, Mane Tahere. Morena, no mai haramai. Ki parakuhi. Thank you for joining us this morning. Rāhui, in the first instance, let's talk about that and what that actually looks like for Kaikohe.
Yeah, it's a bit of a different lens than what we're used to around rāhui. It's around conservation, preservation of whenua and ngāhere. We thought when we got together as the five hapū to use the same mechanism but against prohibition on gang violence. And it was really a different kind of rāhui. But what the situation called for was preservation, really, of life. Mm. We all knew at some point if it got worse, our tamariki mokopuna may have been in the crossfire, so we took the step up and as hapū took the ownership of that rāhui and placed it over our town.
When we talk about hapū, we're talking about sub-tribes within the area of Kaikohe, yeah. Right? So you got together and decided we need to do something about this, which was the rāhui.
Aye.
Did it work?
It did. We're calling it a huge success. Recently we've met with police and they've mentioned to us prior to that rāhui going in place there were up to 27 call-outs, and that's their measure of success, I suppose, on how many calls they get. Mm. And in Kaikohe and the surrounding area, 27 a day. Immediately after, the day after, there were zero. And that zero call-out number lasted for 3 weeks. In the complete 4 weeks, there was only one serious, but hey, that is huge for Kaikohe. And so the police came to meet with us and say, you know, this is effective. How do we package this up? What did you do? And us as hapū know that it's a tikanga of ours and that we believe in it, but to have that measure come through, we call it quite a success. But it also led to a whole range of other things and long-term solutions that we're looking at. It led to a truce between the gangs, and so it was hugely effective for our community.
Why do you think it was effective? And have conversations been had with the gangs to find out why they actually adhered to that rāhui and they called the truce between the two gangs and it stayed that way for weeks?
Effectively, this is the power, I suppose, and the wairua and the spirit of our tikanga is that the onus at the end of that rāhui went back on individuals and whānaus, and one way or another, whether we like it or not, we're connected to these gang members, to these different groups.
Yeah.
And so the onus went back on. There were conversations in whānaus to talk about what this rāhui means. It's a different approach from perhaps a punitive approach from
the one we saw in that story just before.
Yeah. And so I think it was really the onus and the pressure being back, because at the end of the day, these five hapū, and all hapū for that matter, they sit on the taumata, they do the cleaning in the kitchen and the cooking, and no matter who or what group you're part of, you end up going back to marae and to your whānau. So there was a different element or entry point or conversation than what could happen from authorities.
Mm.
So it was a different āhua about it. And I think that, and with some of the conversations at home, that's really what the approach was. What you're seeing here is a rise up of that kind of approach, especially for ngāpui, it's always been around hapū.
Mm-hmm.
Hapū, but as hapū modernise and stand up and look at their structures, they're able to do more of this kind of mahi, and actually that leads to the long-term solutions, because we're there, we've been there, we're always going to be there.
Mm. Have police actually tapped on the door and said, hey, what are you guys doing? And do you think that this approach could work here in Tāmaki Makaurau? So, you know, we're talking about Kaikohe, 4,500 people here, 1.6 million. Do you reckon it could work here?
I would be hopeful. I mean, it's around the mana and the ihi that mana whenua give effect to in these instances, because that mechanism and tool is essentially Māori. And police have knocked on Kaikohe's door and looked at, you know, how can we do this perhaps in other small towns like ours? I suppose it's the long-term solutions that I think will be probably more effective, as the rāhui being the beginner, because
yep.
For Kaikohe, we're looking at in December a Te Ahotanga festival, but that leads back to whānau, gang or not, engaging in marae cultural activities, waiata, haka, all of these things. And so those are some of the long term. I know that can apply in Auckland, it already is,
yep.
But if it's wrapped around this kaupapa, renaissance of culture, all of those kind of kaupapa, I think it could, but it's up to the mana whenua essentially to mana that and really give it, drive behind. Because if they do their job well, then the onus again will go back on the individual. It's that reach, right? It's that without going to meet one-to-one, it's put out, it's executed well, and then, yeah. It's up to the individual.
He mahi whakahira here, he mahi rangatira tēnā. Mane, thank you so much for giving us an insight into what is working and potential for it to work around the motu. Mane, Tahere, from te tiahotanga, tēnā koe.
Kia ora.